What's going on, guys? My name is Crafting Bricks, and today we have a beautiful video. I'm showing you guys all the super packs ever made in a series, making it a little bit funny and spicy. Check it out right now. Alright, guys, as you can see here, we have every single battle pack here on the screen right now, and we've got 5 sections. So we've got God tier. We've got all, which is, you know, all right. Mid, obviously mid is mid. Then we've got meh, which isn't that good, and trash. So we're gonna rank all of the super packs ever made. And if you guys don't know, we just finished the collection of super packs, which is in our couple of videos below, but it's in the description below if you wanna check that out. Well, let's get straight into ranking these super packs for you. And, you know, talking a little bit about them and telling you the price and when they were released. Let's try it out. Alright, guys, starting it off with the first battle pack here. We've got the LEGO Galactic Adventures pack set. It's set number 66708, which is the newest super pack we've actually made. LEGO has made, and this one's right here. And I'm gonna say, because it is including those shitty little duel on Mandalore and the Marauder and stuff like that, I really think it's not that great, so I'm gonna put it on mid for now. We might change it later, but this was released in 2022, as you know. The second set that we're gonna be talking about is the Luke Skywalker's Adventure Pack. And the price for this set was actually really good. It's around $110, and you can get a good deal for 3 sets. So I'm gonna say that's an all set for a 2021, is it? Set, it's a really good deal there. Then we got a couple of the new ones, like the Jawa / First Order Battle Pack. Those battle packs were meh. I'm gonna put it on meh, which isn't that great. Then we've got, what else do we got here? We've got, let's start off with the small 3-in-1s. So we've got this Spider Droid with the Snow Trooper Battle Pack, and the Micro Fighters are all mid. The Spider Droid is alright, it's not that great. This one's actually alright, the Archon 72 Gunship. This is an all set. Then we've got the Turbo Tech Millennium Falcon and the AAT, and I think that one is really all. Oh, then we have the X-Wing Interceptor and Star Destroyer. That's trash. That's trash, guys. Don't ever buy that set. That's trash. Then we've got the Phantom with the Walker ATDP, and I think that's a Snow Speeder or a Tantive or something like that. Oh, it's a First Order Speeder. I think that's a meh. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think of that one. It's not really anything to be talking about highly. Then we've got the Interceptor, another First Order kind of shuttle there with the Wookiee gunship, and I want to put that on there. It's not that great. We've got the this battle pack with the kind of Jedi battle pack was actually really good, so I'm gonna put it on all. This one's really good with the Stormtroopers. And then we've got the last one, which I really think is trash.
Oh my god, bro.
Going on the advanced 3-in-1 with the 2 Rebel Scout Trooper Battle Pack and the Stormtrooper Battle Pack. The Stormtrooper Battle Pack itself makes it a set. Then we've got the gunship with the Obi-Wan buildable figure, and I think the combination of them both fighting kind of makes it a however, because they're buildable figures and no one likes those, we're actually gonna put it on mid. Same thing as the Luke versus Darth Vader, they're both just mid. Now the god tier of them all is the Phantom and the Ghost 3-in-1. That is a godly set. That around 1,100 bucks right
ain't
now.
Ain't no fucking way.
You can find one for less than
ain't
that.
No way,
you get it right now. That's a god tier set. The second one we've got is actually another combination between the Clone Trooper Battle Pack and the Spider Droid. The Spider Droid is kind of trash, but the tank and the Clone Troopers make it a set. The Snow Battle Packs, the 3-in-1s, are really good in terms of army building. However, they're not going to be god tier, so they're going to be around mid. So is the Womp Harvest set. The Land Speeder one is meh. That one that we're not even going to talk about. Then we've got the Cannon, which is alright. I think that's a mid. Another speeder there. We're going to put up meh. This Sith speeder is... everyone's been telling me that they've liked it and stuff. The 66395. However, I don't really like it. The Mandalorian Battle Pack is in there, which will make it a maybe a mid. Now, the Naboo Starfighter. I love this one. And that's definitely easy OO set. Now, the next three are god tier sets. And I'm telling you right now, we've got the AT-T with these... Corporate Alliance tank. It's a beautiful, beautiful set, and you can get it for around $1,000 right now. But I think it's a beautiful combination in between sets, and that's why he's going to god tier 100%. Then we've got the fan favorite Captain Phase 2 Rex with our little scammer Plee Krong. Whatever his name is, but he is in the set, and I'm in the set as well. 2014 for LEGO Star Wars was definitely a good year. Then we've got the cannon itself makes it a really good set. I know the other Anakin Starfighter and the little attack there is not that good. So it might not be a god tier, but it will be definitely an OO, easy OO. Then we've got a Y-Wing, and Y-Wings are a lot made, and I'm just going to put it at mid. Then I've got a Corporate Alliance tank, which is mid. And then we've got the TIE Fighter, which we bought a long time ago, but however, it is a mess set. Then we got the Toys R Us exclusive. Now, this is one that's not frequently talked about. I do love the speeder in there with the set. I think it's a really neat little set, and that's why we're gonna put it in. And last but not least, we've got another Snowtrooper, which is just meh. If you guys want to say download this list and have a look for yourself which super packs you are missing, make sure to check it out. And thank you guys so much for watching, and stay tuned for our little tier list video. It is something different from all the other videos we've done. However, hope you enjoyed our video today, and make sure to like and subscribe for more videos like this, and let us know in the comments below what you'd like to see next. The next video is a $5,000 LEGO Star Wars minifigure. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe, and see you guys in the next video. Peace. Yeah.